Right. Do feel free to come a little bit closer if you want to, but basically, if you can't hear or can't see, like I said, the seated set of baduanjin is extremely useful for anybody who's bedridden, anybody in a wheelchair, etc. Now, it's good for you to know, because you never know what position life brings you next, as many people don't do. We're going to be sitting. These chairs aren't ideal because of the curvature of the seat, but you need to try and get a nice flat-footed position with your knees and your body at right angles. Okay, so you need to have 90-degree angles to the knees, 90-degree angle to the back. Don't lean back on the back of the seat, don't lean forwards. Now, for the most part, when we're not doing anything with our hands, we can leave the hands in the backs of the palms, what we call cloud hand in Tai Chi, cloud hand, sun palm, okay? Or sun palm, cloud palm, whichever. Basically, you can leave the backs of the hands on the legs. Any clues as to why we're doing this? Come on, you old hands at Tai Chi. Yeah, you're not. If you've got your palms on your legs, basically you're influencing the flow of qi from the palms through the legs. So we're trying not to let the qi flow where we don't want it to go at present, or when we are in a neutral position. Right, now the first exercise, as you know, is two hands push the sky. But you're keeping a nice straight back, keeping your head up, but trying to keep your tailbone down as well. So you want to lift yourself up so that you're backside comes off the seat. So from that nice first position, gazing at the horizon, we start the first movement, which is the hands are already turned over, so we start with the qi coming down, and then scoop the hands forward and up. Two hands push the sky, push, stretch, little relax, leave the eyes on the horizon, come back down. Come back to neutral. Okay. Do the same again. Follow the hands up, look between the fingertips as you push. Come back down. Back to neutral. And again. Three, do one more. It's so good the next door neighbour's dog wants to join in as well. So one more. Bring your hands over, scoop down towards, push, relax. Good. And relax. Centre your chi. As we're in a static position, you do this with your full consciousness, using your mind or your mind's eye to centre the chi at the down to the end. Okay. And from there, separate heaven and earth. Now, this is where people who are using a wheelchair with handles and wheels or whatever may need to adjust the arm position slightly. But otherwise, you bring your hands up into the beginning position there, take your left hand up, right hand down. Also, of course, if somebody's sitting on a bed, you might find that the edge of the bed gets in the way. After a little stretch, swap over. Again, if somebody was on a bed and the bed's getting in the way, they'd have to take the hand out to the side a little bit more. But otherwise, stretch, allow your body to twist slightly as you stretch both hands apart. Fingertips pointing outwards. Excellent. And two more like that each side. Gazing at the horizon between. by centering your chi down to the end as you go back to neutral position. Good. And number three, looking behind you is a little bit trickier in a chair, because if you're in a chair or a wheelchair or bed bound, you can't swing your legs around. We don't want you to swing your legs around. It's for strengthening the back as much as anything else and encouraging the flow of chi along the spine, as well as working the nervous system and all the muscles around the spine. So keeping the hands where they are, exhale as you turn and look as far as you can over your left shoulder. Inhale as you centre, exhale as you turn the other way. Good. And again, four times each way. Remember, we're doing half of the prescribed set, which is normally eight exercises, eight times each way. Exhale as you turn. Good. And again, try and look as far as you can. Really try and work the spine. Very, very important for somebody who's semi-paralysed and in a wheelchair to try and work the spine and the nervous system as much as possible. And even people who are bed bound. One more each side. And although we haven't moved the hands, you can just think about centering your chi. If you wish to do this, it's not compulsory, but if you wish to do that, you can center your chi, come back to neutral. Okay, right. That takes us to number four, which is the horseback archer. Conveniently, we are sat on our four-legged horse. Okay, so from the basic position, make your bow, left hand in front. Draw the bow and pull it to the left. Stretching a little bit at the end of the motion, as though you're fully pulling the bow, release the arrow. Dissolve the bow, right hand in front. Now stretch, release the bow string, and dissolve the bow. Left hand in front, go to the left. Fingertips pointing to the ceiling. A straight line across the arms and shoulders. Good. Let's do one more each side. Make sure that you have a nice straight line. Stretch. Look at the fingertips of the two fingers pointing up to the ceiling. Center your chi. Back down again. Relax. Back to the neutral position. If you're in a neutral position, you want to just close the fingers off in a fairly natural way, that's fine. Okay. Now, from there, if you're doing that in a more advanced fashion and you're a little bit more able bodied, you might want to make a little bit more waist movement as you draw the bow, and you may want to flow with the exercise a little bit, you know. And it's good to actually relax the waist. Anybody who's beginning in the exercises, especially seated or, you know, like wheelchair users or bedridden or whatever, obviously needs to stretch as much as possible and exercise the waist to get that mobility back into it. And when you're more advanced, like I said, you can more or less relax a little bit more and let the whole thing flow. So bear that one in mind. Okay, the next one. The bending forwards as though searching the ground and clouds. So, obviously, if you're in a wheelchair, you might be able to lean forwards and get your hands down into a position for the next one, which is scooping the stream. This is what I meant to say, searching the ground cloud and scooping the stream, right? Start again. Busy day. Right, so the next one is scooping.
We know what it looks like if that helps.
Something's wrong with it.
Bending forwards and scooping the stream is number seven. Six, sorry, not six. This one is searching the ground and clouds. Right now, for searching the ground and clouds, we put the hands on there. That's hukai, tiger mouth. Tiger mouth on the top of the leg. This is where it gets good. Right now, we're trying to keep the back as straight as possible. Exhale as you lean forwards. Obviously, you don't want to inhale and cramp the lungs. Lean around to the side and look up diagonally in front of you. Okay? So you're trying not to lean back too far. Forwards, exhale. And diagonally looking up in front of you. Allow the shoulders to relax and roll. And around again. Exhale as you go through the centre. May feel that you are slightly massaging the muscles around the base of the spine as you do this, especially as you lean back. You're kind of pivoting the spine but also massaging on one side or the other. Do another one each way. Feel what it's doing. Very important to feel the exercise and feel what it's doing, which parts of the body it's working or affecting. And then back through the middle. Again, centre the tree. Tree centre, but down again. Now we can go to bending as though scooping water from the stream and washing. But in a bed, obviously, it's not going to be possible to lean forwards further than that. In a wheelchair, it may be, depending on the person's balance and ability to stretch and lean forwards. Okay? So it has to be adapted, like all exercises have to be adapted to suit the individual. We're going to try and do the best we can. So we're going to bring the arms up, bringing your chi up to the top of the head, and as we lean forwards and start to bend as though scooping water, we try and visualize the chi flowing to the top of the head. Come back up, allow the chi to flow down through the head, neck and shoulders, and wash down through the body, just like water flowing down from a mountaintop. Good, and again. Get the chi flowing to the top of the head. Washing down through the body. Visualize, use your mind's eye to visualize the chi washing down through the body. Again. As we're reasonably able, we'll do one simple one. Try and get your hands down towards your feet. Let your head hang. Come back up. To supplement that, anybody in a wheelchair or bedridden or whatever could actually do a kidney rub after that. So you can do a little kidney rub just to stimulate the kidney area. And that's using what we call the ridgetile hand. Which is there, thumb tucked in. We push that in and rub the kidney to try and stimulate the flow through the kidney. Slantwise punching and glaring with tiger eyes, as you know from when you're doing the standing basic set or the advanced set, try not to point your fist directly at another person. Aim in between people and over their heads, so to speak, because your chi will be flowing quite strongly. So, coming from here, again, loose fist, bring your hand up diagonally, start by punching, glaring with tiger eyes, stretch that first knuckle joint out as far as possible, stretching the whole arm out, head raised, tailbone down, glaring at the fist with tiger eyes, then relax, come back in, do the same on the other side. Good, well done. Right, and on each side, try and consciously move that chi up into the palm of the hand as you punch, looking into the eye of the fist. Then bring the chi back to the dantian as you return. And then of course we can center as normal. You're going to bring the chi up the back over the front, down to the dantian. Now those who know baduanjin already, we know that this is the safer, simplified set. You may know that you normally stand on tiptoe and bounce at this point. Now, anybody who's a little bit on the sickle debilitated side may not be able to stand up and bounce, so what we try and do is to raise ourselves up as much as possible, so you feel your backside almost lifting off the seat, and then we drop. It's wise to inhale as you stretch up, let the breath go as you drop, okay? So this is shaking, this is number 8, shaking the internal organs back into place. Just stretch up. Let go. Now you'll feel that pumping action on the base of the spine. One more time, you'll feel that if that's your tailbone, as your tailbone lifts and you sit back down, you get that pumping action on the base of the tailbone, the coccyx, and that's where the nervous system starts as well. So it's actually, this pumping action is actually helping in some way towards kind of charging the nervous system or helping the nervous system sort of to kick into action a little bit more, if you like. It's like a massage for the nervous system, if you want to put it in very simple terms, and that might actually help anybody who's, like I said, sort of somewhat debilitated or in a wheelchair, etc. And then, of course, to finish, we again center the chi, come back to that neutral position if you haven't already, and we use our little affirmation, which can be anything positive, such as being relaxed and centered. I always think that everybody after baduanjin should give themselves a little mental pat on the back as well and say, well done for doing an exercise which helped me to feel better. I shall do that every day. In fact, 2 or 3 times a day. You can try this at home. Okay. Wonderful. Well, I thought I'd say that as a note for people. How do you feel after that? The legs haven't worked much, but we've certainly worked the body. You should notice a difference between the legs and the body. Okay? But we'll soon remedy that with some Tai Chi Chuan. Excellent. Well done, Bruce. Thank you.
missing people.